You're wasting time. Get over there now! Looks like you're not up to this mission. Breaking contact.
Good Friday, everybody. Hello. It is Friday the 13th. July 13th, specifically. And today is Wheel of Rip. It's Friday. And we are playing some BattleTech today. So, big thank you to a certain someone who requested the game. Man, it's still always weird to me of having an intro video without hearing the audio. I know I say that all the time, but it's still something that's like foreign to me. But anyways, hello. Just wanted to give you guys all the heads up. I still feel like a tiny bit tired, but everything else, I am great and I'm doing well and I'm ready to play some video games today. I'm ready to see more and more what this game is all about. I hope we have fun and I hope we don't rip a game today. Happy Rusev Day. Happy Rusev Day to you too, Master Ray, it is good to see you. Originally, I was going to wear this dorky Shadow Jago mask, but then I was like, not going to happen. So I'm just kind of having a quick moment here before we get everything started. But glad to see you guys here. Should be a fun time. And here, let me get this up over here. There we go. Nice, looking good. One thing I wanted to check here real quick. Oh, cool. Sound, you probably want sound on. What's this? This is, not Crescent Hawk's Revenge. This is Crescent Hawk's Inception. So, Ray, for you, because you probably have no idea what this is. This game is called BattleTech. So think of BattleTech if you're familiar with the Gundam series. Oh yeah, here. Hang on, let's listen to... There's not much music in this game. So I was thinking about having just some kind of mech music and synthwave and cyberpunk music that I feel is fitting for me. If I'm piloting huge robots that can just crush a little human being. So, we're going to listen to a little Gundam Battle Assault. Anyways, so, BattleTech. I still don't know a whole lot about it, but basically, like, think of it as the, Mom might be able to give more of a history lesson on it. He's the one who requested this game. But think of it as like a westernized Gundam, basically. You got people piloting mechs. Yeah, that game's dead though. I'm not playing that game. So, no thank you. Dude, I'm done playing Friday the 13th, unfortunately, with... I have played it once on a 13th. Like, don't get me wrong. It would be fun to play it, but... I'm not playing a game that is not supporting itself anymore. It's like, I've... Here, let's do this. I want to see something here. Friday the 13th. Where are you at? I've played over 155 hours in that game. I'm fine. I'm cool. So, oh! Oh, the NES one. Okay. I thought he was saying more like play 80s music and play Friday the 13th. I have already played that. And that game's hard as balls. Very, very challenging. I had really no idea what to do. So. But BattleTech, I kind of know what to do. I got a little hand, a little help. just kind of so I don't have a, so I can have a better experience playing this game versus, you know, a not so great, more of a rip experience. I kind of have a chance of getting to play this game. It's a very, very simple game. No, I went over your head, bro. But anyways, yeah, so this is where we are. This is your main character, Jason. But see, here's the thing. Here's the thing, Ray. You need a, like, dude, you didn't even think about it. Yeah, it's Friday the 13th. But you know who I'm playing? I'm playing as Jason. Jason Voorhees, hello? He's a BattleTech pilot. Like, did you ever... Wow, you didn't even know that. That's lore you just missed right there. Nice try, buddy. Hey. Typed. Not said. No, it's all what. It's all good. Again, I said earlier, I'm a little sleep deprived. My schedule is a little wonky with sleeping last night, working, sleeping more. So, apologies. It's all good, though. But yeah, I've played both of those Friday the 13th games, and like, I don't know, I've gotten my fix, and that's that, honestly. Alright, so I need to catch myself up here, because it's been a hot minute. Invisible cup pipe, always. So, Comstar Station, this is again, I think, with the, yeah, with the stock. Okay. So right now I think I need to do is make more bills. I wonder how I can I talk to people? Or not. Here, I'm gonna do this real quick. Yeah, so this is still, like, also the first zone in the game, too. Yeah, that's the plan. Leave the barracks. Nobody seems to be around here. Guess we'll leave the barracks. Yeah, I've done one training mission too, and it was kind of a struggle. Yeah, I'm not sure also how to talk to people still. Alright, weapon shop. Oh, only when they go in a building. Okay. Interesting. Oh, I can just walk over water. Cool. Jesus confirmed. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to probably find these people. Yeah, like this guy. Right here, let's follow him. Where's this kid going? Jeff Rogers. Hi, Jason. How are you? I just stopped in here to boogie. After I'm done here, I'm going over to the training center. You're a BattleTech pilot. You're getting ready to train and go beat some ass later. Entryway to a huge battle mech. Repair center. Ask to apprentice. Visit speed shop. There's someone else in here. Fred Swenson. Hi, Jason. How are you? I just stopped in here to watch the men work and see if I can't learn something after I'm done here. I'm going over to the Citadel. I want to see how much that is. 500 bills, huh? I'm not going to be able to do that. But yeah, right now the whole thing that I'm trying to do, Ray, is get money. I'm going to follow him now and see what he says. Is the Citadel, like, the hot spot to talk to these NPCs? Alright. I think there was someone else in here. Wait. Not sure why that mission happened. Other cadets snicker as you leave the training center. Oh yeah, I think this is... Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't even pay attention to that mission. I was looking for, to see if I could chat to someone. But yeah, I'll go to the Citadel. Other cool thing in this game that, is really neat about it is... It's not a WASD game. Like, you can actually use just the, like, the number pad for all the directions. But yeah, whatever. Can I... Oh, man. Don't come back till you do your mission. I didn't even read. Corey doesn't read. Hello? Chat? Reading? Type to learn? Actually have to... Can I abandon the mission? Actually, here. Let's do this. Well, I mean, I can't, like, pause or leave or do shit. Alright, cool. Nice. Game over already. Can we just attack again, right? Or, oh no, I gotta mount first. Alright, so you, again, were saying the Citadel. That's a wasp, by the way. Okay. Alright, so that's Comstar. I think Citadel's a little more to the left. I thought this was the Citadel, but I could be hella mistaken. Actually, I need to get used to just using the numpad middle. Oh, this one here. Nope. Oh, you mean middle as in the middle of the, that building, walk in the middle, the big one. Oh, just like, I think, yeah, there we go. Okay, cool. Let's see here. You're standing in the House Steiner Citadel, the center of Lyran Commonwealth operations on Pacifica. Will you... Let's go see Katrina first, I guess. The sentry recognizes you as the son of the captain of security forces and informs you, Katrina, that you wish to speak to her. She agrees, and you are escorted into her plush offices. Hello, Jason. How are you? How is your training coming? I see that you have been to the training center. Your last mission was quite successful, wasn't it?
Not really.
Well, must be off. I have preparations to make for the wedding, you know. Wedding? What wedding? Alright, visit Hall of Legends. Our first exhibit is a portrait of the Archon herself, Katrina Steiner, Duchess of Tharkad. Katrina is here on Pacifica for a short while on her way to the Federated Suns for the marriage of her daughter Melissa. Here we have a picture of one of the many battle mechs that help to protect our Commonwealth from the Lyo Merrick, or protect our Commonwealth from the Lyo Merrick and Kurita invaders. Alright, so they're like different tribes or factions. Let's see, this example is a Locust, a very common mech. It is armed with a medium laser and machine guns instead of hands. This is an extremely rare mech, a Phoenix Hawk, LAM, or LAM. Oh, houses, okay. So it's like Warhammer, in a way then. This mech can convert from a normal mech to a aerospace fighter, or a hybrid mode pictured here. There are very few mech warriors who can pilot these complex machines. Perhaps the most skilled and famous is our own security chief, Jeremiah Youngblood. Can I pilot one of those? This is Edward Tellum, an extremely brilliant scientist responsible for much of the recovered technology we have today. He is also somewhat eccentric and retired somewhere north on Pacifica to be away from people. Some rumors say that he is still alive, but he hasn't been seen in years. Maybe he'll join our party later. Depicted here is one of the Defiance Industries battle mech factories on Hesperus, or Hesperus 2. This is one example of the Commonwealth's superiority in manufacturing and commerce among the successor states. Our last exhibit shows the Battle of Mallory's World. 12 years ago, here is a lance of the Steiner mercenary unit. Kellhounds fought off a determined Kurita invasion. The hounds stayed hidden in the trees, where they were difficult to hit, while Jeremiah Youngblood used his lamb's superior maneuverability to drive the Dracos away. Yeah, I can't do that yet. Alright. Well, did some talking. Maybe there's someone else in... Kind of cool background story. I just kind of wish there was some pictures. Would be cool to see some artwork of that stuff. 200, huh? Where are you kids going? pulled a fast one on me. Simon Hampton. Hi, Jason. How are you? I just stopped in here to watch the men work and see... Dude, talking to these guys is just kind of lame. They ain't doing shit for me. I mean, I could see if my money went up after talking to those people. Doubtful, but maybe. Do the training. I don't think I have enough money to do the training, though. Oh, okay. Just go do the mech missions then? Okay. Got it. All right. Yeah, you need to, like, trigger kind of, like, special events or doing, like, the training missions that will kind of, like, proc the money. It's definitely different in this kind of, like, older game. It's not, like, a thing where you just wait over time. Yeah, okay, we might get screwed. Right. Every time I get paid. Alright. Before you can go on a training mission, you will have... pass, oh yeah, which is just Greetings, Cadet Youngblood. Congratulations on successfully completing your last training mission. Are you ready to accept your second training mission? Sure. Your second training mission is only slightly more complex. Somewhere on the field is a piece of rubble. Choose a mech, go out there, find the rubble, pick it up, and bring it back. There is no time limit in this mission. Okay, cool. Other cadets snicker. You leave the training room. Alright, so... You realize your locust has no hands and can't pick it up. Oh, shit. So how do I... Oh, that's why they laughed at me. Yeah, gotcha. Alright, we gotta wait a second then. It's a good lesson to learn. So... Mom... Who is it, the wasp or chameleon that has the hands? Yeah, gotta play the stock market. Yeah, and again, like, the mom giving me his guidance and wisdom is helping me have a better experience than just kind of going in rough and just, like, not knowing much about the game. I think that's beneficial for me because I can probably play this game and appreciate it a lot more than just, you know, going in without knowing much about it. Alright, so I gotta find that piece of rubble again. Kind of looked like an antenna. Oh, totally. Totally. Just like Fire Emblem back in the day. I just have to use my imagination more. You use your mech's hands to retrieve the rubble. Totally.
Well done, Cadet. You wisely chose a mech with hands so you could pick up the rubble.
report back here for your next mission later. So now I need to wait till I get my 15 bills, right? Alright, so now... now we go check to make sure that everything worked out. Damn, look at these pack of goons! So now I hope that I make money. I don't think I would get 30. I haven't done anything else. Yeah, look at that. I'm good. So then... change investments. Buy stock. I think it was this one again. Right? The pharmacy? I'll wait a moment for the stream to catch up to make sure this is right. Yeah, I'll take that out in a moment. Okay, then, yeah. Cool. No, go save since you made money. Oh, okay. Alright, so then let's leave Comstar. And then I'm just gonna save under game 2. Alright, so inspect your accounts. And then change investments. Sell stock. And I want... don't? Okay. All right. I don't think I'm going to make any more bills, but do this for a quick minute. Yeah, I think we're good. Alright, okay. Alright, so now I go to the Citadel. Right, and then I'll need to go check it again. Let's see here. And I'm doing rifles and SMGs again, right? That's what we're doing? Too bad I don't use blades. I would really like to use, like, blades on a mech. Like, that's the thing, like... just a bit about me enjoying, you know, I love mechs. I'm more about the Japanese mechs. And, you know, you say blades are worthless, but, I mean, I guess this is, you know, this is BattleTech. It's not Gundam. They don't have particle beam swords. They don't have beam scythes. They just got weeaboo swords, I guess. Oh, personal combat skills, not mech skills. Oh, excuse me, I didn't even know that. Okay, that brings more perspective. I mean, yeah, because we're not at the mech training facility. That, yeah, true. By looking at your transcript, I see you are an amateur with a rifle or submachine gun. After several grueling hours in the classroom at the hands of a skilled instructor, you have mustered a passing grade. Better yet, you feel more confident with the weapons and are more accurate and effective with them. You are informed that the school has already transferred the tuition funds from your ComStar accounts so you have paid in full. Okay. So now we go walk for a bit. And I should get paid again. Cool, there we go. So now let's go hope we make money. Inspect my account. And I lost money. So now I need to load my game. And then try it again. Yeah. Nice. There we go. So then, change investments. Actually, here. I'll wait to see what, I'll wait on mom. I'll put the money in and save. All right. Actually, you know what? No, we're gonna save this for, like, combat. Here, let's I need more mech music. One I do need. Alright, so let's go training. Before you can go on training mission, you will have to pass the written quiz again. Greetings, Cadet Youngblood. Congratulations on successful completing your last training mission. Yes, we are ready for our next one. The commandment, or wait, the commandant of the training center stops you before you can sign up for the mission. He tells you that you look pretty tired and should get some rest before trying the next mission. Ah, okay, so we gotta go. We need to go to the barracks and go sleep. So let's catch some Z's. You drift off in a contented sleep. You awaken to the sound of sirens blaring and warnings to all the cadets. House Merrick agents have infiltrated the Citadel and are holding Katrina hostage. They are demanding immediate Steiner evacuation of the planet. All around you, your friends and fellow cadets are gathering their equipment and rushing for the starport. You grab your clothes and dress quickly, but you're not going to turn tail and run. No, the only thing you're packing is a vibroblade and not in a suitcase. Vibroblade, that's in Star Wars. Katrina has provided a good living for your family, and you're not going to leave her to those Merrick terrorists. You slip out the window and make your way through the trees to the Citadel. You peek over the low wall, right into the eyes of a Merrick watchman. He is as surprised as you are, but you're quicker, and he's now headless. You drag the body behind a building and swap uniforms, but you loathe even touching this infidel. You walk through the front entrance of the Citadel, grunting at the sentries posted there. A Merrick officer stops you in the main hall, questioning you about the blood that is covering your collar. You explain that the blood is just like your filthy mud. You scream as you plunge the vibroblade into his gut. Footsteps are scrambling from around the corner before you, and you realize you've blown. You realize your cover is blown. You duck into a closet and perfectly executed gymnastic flare. He's like a wrestler. Hey, what's up, Ivy Joe? Good to see ya. Welcome to Wheel of Rip Friday. We are playing some BattleTech tonight. Old school DOSBox game. Let's see here. You leap to grab a light fixture, slice a hole in the roof with the white-hot vibroblade. I mean, it's kind of like a lightsaber. And escape into the ventilation shafts in the ceiling. Drawing upon your photographic memory, you visualize the floor plan to the Citadel. You stealthily make your way to Katrina's office, where they are most certainly holding her. You peer through the vent and see Katrina tied up in a chair, slap marks covering her left cheek. You have arrived just in time to see the grungy leader of the Merrick invaders rear back his hand, and he stops and grabs his ears, as you do also because of the loud siren sounding. Then a voice comes through, "Jason Youngblood, report to the Mech Warrior Training Center, Jason Youngblood." You sit bolt upright in bed and realize it was all a dream. Rubbing your eyes, you climb out of bed and get dressed again. That was kind of cool. Let's see if you get paid first. Yeah. See if we get paid. See, that's the thing I like about this game, though. You kind of get to use your imagination, which is fun, with like these kind of old school games. What up, broski? Nah, I think you're good. All right, cool. Let's go do that mission. Let's go get my mech and see if... Dude, hopefully we get to do combat. Yeah, that's avoiding the puddles emote. Will you enter the training center? Yeah, my brain dead mission here. Alright, third mission. Yes, I am. Don't insult chicken wings. Dude, I didn't even... Do you see this chicken above me? You see this blue chicken up here? Dude, this is a safe haven for all chicken wing lovers. But dude, you might like this game. This is like old school Western, like Gundam mechs. BattleTech, dude. Crescent chicken. By now, you're pretty good at walking around. Thanks. I'm not a baby anymore. I'm a toddler. It's obvious you have increased your piloting skill. We're going to see how you handle using your weapons. We've put a worthless locust shell on the field for you to go pummel. It can't move or fire, so you're perfectly safe. Choose your mech and go plaster it. Ooh, plaster. Just use chameleon. Got it. Burn. Do you want the computer to fight for you? I'm assuming I'm gonna say no. Right? Hey, man. If I can survive Sword of Sodan for like 5 minutes, I think I can survive BattleTech for 10 minutes of combat. We'll see. I'm assuming I'm gonna say no. Oh, you gotta go? Hey, dude, always appreciate the check-in. Any and every time, man. You have a good night. Then no. Combat message. Brief, verbose. You know, I will say, Oro's one of the most unique Street Fighter characters ever. Verbose. See combat graphics? Yes. Oh! Alright, here we go. Oh, shit. So, this is kind of like a, this is very reminiscent to, like, Final Fantasy Tactics. Cool. So, I'm gonna go walk. Oh, I get movement steps, actually, too. Alright, here, actually. I'm gonna jump. This mech is now walking. Do you wish to jump? Nah, I don't know yet. Scan unit is something you're going to do all the time. It shows you where enemies are. Okay, let's do that first then. Enemies. Okay, so he's all the way over there. Is there any other units? Detailed scan. Oh, cool. Show stats. Can't walk any further this turn. Huh. Okay. So that's my stuff. Okay. You want to switch between... So wait, so you want me to run now? You can't run any further this turn. Press A key. So, I'm gonna jump, then. Takes more heat. Oh. Didn't say begin fight. Ah, okay. Gotcha. 10 months, baby. Thank you, Crazy. Yo, this nerd's doing good. I hope you're doing well. Oh, Panda Pete! Can assign weapons to target before you can begin a fight. Okay, it's before in turn. Well, I'm not even close to this guy yet, and he can't do shiz to me. So then, let's just do, like, begin fight. Okay, cool. So now it's, like, my next turn. But here's the thing. There's trees in the way, so... Don't ask me, Dad. I will mod your ass. Oof. Yeah, totes. Alright. But you can aim now. Alright, so now let's try using a weapon. Let's use my medium laser. Target here. That weapon is already going to be fired. Override? No. Oh, can I fire a small laser too? Range out. Cancel. Done. Okay, cool. Okay, I don't think I hit him then. Or do I need to get closer? Oh, okay. So maybe run a bit more. And maybe... If you overheat, it's bad. Oh, okay. Gotcha. Oh, yeah. Whole year. Okay. Ooh, shot him! Pew. It's going a little too fast, so I can't see where it's hitting him. Oh, crits too. Maybe, I could fire multiple weapons? I mean, I don't want to go overboard, though. It's background music because this game doesn't have any, so I'm playing kind of, you know, music I feel fitting. So, just kind of nice, fun, relaxing, nostalgic music of, things that's either, like, mech, Gundam, synthwave, cyberpunk related. This is the Valhalla soundtrack. It's elevator music. I don't know about that. Alright, cool. It's destroyed. Also, machine guns don't take heat. At least, they shouldn't. But they do, like, very little... damage. But infantry, they will kill. Okay. So, save. Probably save it for, like, things that aren't mech-related. Alright, so now we're done. Now I can buzz off. Not much left out there, is there? Of course! Incredible firepower of the chameleon let you demolish the target in no time. If you paid attention to your heat scale, You should have noticed how high it went. Go get cleaned up, and we'll let you try a hand at some real combat next. And probably will have to. Okay, just to prevent heat and all that. Yeah, I'll need to be better at monitoring heat. Alright, so I should get 15 bills again. There we go. Alright, so now hopefully we made a profit. I think I... No, I didn't profit. Nope. Okay. So now we got a load game. But that's okay. That means this is more practice for me. And I think it was on save one. Yeah, okay, cool. So 331. Oh yeah, because we dropped hella hard because I had like 300. Yeah. Yeah, that sucks. It's fine. And then they're gonna tell me to go to bed. So I can probably just save after. I'll just save on file 2. And then actually 2 to create more closure just in case. I'm gonna check my funds. Save over 1. Yeah, I'm just gonna make sure everything's all good in here, even though I slept for a night. Yeah, okay, cool, we're good. So, save game over 1. Also, I'm gonna do this too, just in case. And then I need backup save files because I'm not trying to fuck up. I'll go to settings. Change the combat tech speed. You mean set combat speed? So should I go like slower? Key press will wait until... Oh, key press? Oh, okay. That's a better idea. Alright. Alright. Burn! No. Alright, so let's see here. So what I'm looking for, so would heat, okay, heat's down there by the backpack piece. I'm assuming it's that green bar by the heat, and I'm at green full bar, so I should be okay, and the heat sinks is all green. Oh yeah. Alright, so let's do a, I'm going to use a, man, I got a lot of fucking lasers. I'm going to use just a Hyper Viper beam. And then also a small laser. And then let's... So now if I scan the unit, everything still seems fine. Should display 10E per turn. I mean, everything seems okay so far. Probably when I start using weapons. Ooh, got him! Okay. So now what I want to see... Missed. Oh, I hit the torso. Okay. So now I want to scan... friends. Maybe because it's the tutorial, everything's fine. Let's use a medium laser, small laser, another medium laser. Let's just kill this guy. There's only 3 heat. But so, this is one thing that I'm kind of curious about. With like, my BattleTech, right? Or with my mech. One thing that's really weird is, like, I have all these different lasers, right? Is my mech actually, like, I see he has a big gun, but... What I'm confused is, are all, like, medium laser, small laser, large laser, medium laser, machine gun, like, does my guy have all these different guns? Or are these just, like in Gundam, for example, usually right by the Gundam's head, they have two little machine gun points where they shoot out machine guns. It's kind of a defensive maneuver, so... That's just what I'm curious about. Oh yeah, see that heat's going up now. I see. Okay. So then let's not use the large laser. Hey, oil. And movement points and shut down. Is there a way to ever cool down your unit? I'm very good, my man. Oh, yeah, see, now it's not using as much heat. It dropped a little bit, I think. Alright, you should return to base. Alright, so now... Don't fire all your weapons every turn, stand in water, don't jump all the time, etc. Okay. Just don't be an idiot. Oh, hell yeah, dude. That double profit, baby.
Nice.
Was it 375 we needed for the next training? Life of being a mech pilot, boys. Okay, deposit and save. Alright, so then... Totally, when I punched my hand, I think I broke one of my hands. When I punched my right hand, I think I just busted it. I don't think I'm gonna get paid again, but it doesn't hurt. Alright, we're good. Let's go get that 375 and go train more. Alright, change investments, sell stock. 375. Leave Comstar. And... Eventually they'll get paid more than once. Gotcha. Okay. I'm gonna save on game 6. Let's go train more. Enroll in combat class. Oh, it's 325. Ah, that's fine. By looking at your transcript, I see you are competent with a rifle or submachine gun. Yeah, it's fine. None in the world. After several grueling hours in the classroom at the hands of a skilled instructor, you have mustered a passing grade. Better yet, you feel more confident with the weapons and are more accurate and effective with them. You're informed that the school has already transferred the tuition funds. Oh, okay, so it's another same thing. Yeah. All right. So that extra 50 might hurt you. So then we'll do this. Change investments, buy stock. So I'm just gonna drop 50. Okay, so now I should get paid again. There we go. There we go. Cool. Change investments, stock. All right. Yep. And let's go do another mission. I do like the combat, though. The combat is very reminiscent of, like, Final Fantasy Tactics or, like, a deeper... Or it's, like, you know, it's a top-down RPG. I love top-down RPGs. So, like, games like Fire Emblem, Advance Wars, all about that. Alright, we'll see. I just kind of wish this game was updated. Like, I wish, like, I actually could, like, have a little guy that, you know, isn't just a little blue speck. A little blue ant. That would be, you know, that'd be nice. Like, if this game got kind of, like, a remastered. It'd look pretty sweet. Okay, you're good. Dude moves fast. But! Capital but. You could go train the last time. You have the money to do now. Okay, I'll go do that. Lord Moldy Butt. $450.
California.
All right, so now I'm gonna save on game one. This is probably my favorite track from this album, by the way. All right, so let's go enroll in combat class, 450. By looking at your transcript, I see you are a whiz. Not a wizard, but a whiz with a rifle or submachine gun. After several grueling hours, once again in the classroom at the hands of a skilled instructor, you have mustered a passing grade. Better yet, you feel more confident with the weapons.
That was pretty wizard.
And are more accurate and effective with them. You're informed that the school has already transferred the tuition funds from your ComStar account, so you have paid in full. No, until tomorrow. Oh, ha! That's one of the commands I actually erased. Alright, so let's see if I made a profit. Yeah, I did tweak some commands, by the way, just letting you guys know. So, I'm pretty certain all of them are updated on the command link. But I feel like there's some that I do need to, like, either add or alter, because I did kind of change their path name. Alright, let's see if I made a profit. I didn't. Rip.
Can you, like, shut up?
Hey, you look like those boys have been whacking off in my tool shed. All right, so now we gotta go do another mission, or should I go do the apprenticeship? Check your skills when you get out here. Bone blade unskilled, pistol unskilled, rifle excellent, gunnery unskilled, piloting adequate. Think of Wayne's World. Excellent. I have a feeling, by the way, just giving you guys a heads up, because I'm not sure how long this game is, but so far, not a bad experience. I don't know how long this game is, but I feel like this might be could be a 2 Friday game. I'd make sure you don't get more money than do training mission. All right, we'll do another Pokemon egg walk. Yeah, dude, my guy runs really fast. I mean, Pete, you know that Sonic the Hedgehog, right? His name's just Jason. He's a DeviantArt fan-made character. I know a couple things. Yo, maybe we should listen to some Sonic Mania.
Don't you get it? I'm not my original character, Bluckles! I'm the actual Knuckles! Trapped in the real world!
Alright, let's go do another mission. Before you can go to the training mission, you'll have to pass the written quiz once again.
Greetings, Cadet Youngblood. Congratulations on successfully completing your last training mission. Are you ready to accept your fourth training mission?
Yeah, dude.
time to see how you respond to a reactionary opponent. We've rounded up a group of old labor robots and outfitted them with rudimentary intelligence and a variety of weapons. Your mission is to go out there and eliminate them without getting your mech shot out from under you. All right. Scan enemies. Oh, they're just little fucking dudes. Laser pistol, a knife. What are you gonna do with a knife? I'm in a mech. Can I just walk on them? Can I kick them? Can I squish them? Dude, look at these little pipsqueaks though. I'll machine gun them. They're done. Nothing, that's what. Yeah. They're like fucking running away. All right. God, they're running in the corner. Yeah, I mean, that's fine. Ooh. Hang on. Okay. Hang on. Yeah. And then maybe a medium laser on him. All right, so I seem okay. Played this Mech Warrior game. I think I played. Oh, there's a SNES one? Actually, I should just get closer to these kids. See ya, kid. You can't walk any further this turn. You might... Oh, did I... Oh, okay. Decent condition still. All right. Oh, dude, he's like fried.
missed. Cool, got him. Can't hit something you're not facing, right? Oh yeah, probably a back shot would really fuck you up because of the backpack thing. Wow. Rear. You said rear. That's what you're missing. Shit. There we go. All right, sweet. Dunskies. Handheld weapons? Okay. Inferno! Cool, Cinder's in this game. Hopefully made money. Oh god, yeah. Very good, Mr. Youngblood. Although shooting up a bunch of androids may not seem like much, you kept your head in a combat situation. Rest of your training missions won't be so easy, however. Yeah, hopefully. So what else am I gonna use my funds on? No, leave Comstar, okay. Load game. Alright, time to go fight these kids again. Again, still, good practice. Don't mind it. I personally don't. I'm personally cool with it. I'm enjoying this game. I'm having fun right now. It helps me learn more, too. Like, that's the bigger part. Weapons and apprentice. Sure. I'll let the computer just do it. But who would want to simulate it? Like, that's kind of weird. Like, thinking about it. Dude, he went a lot more ham than I did. He went no mercy mode. I mean, why not? Hey man, maybe he's got those Call of Duty explosive arrows. I don't know. Maybe he's got Vibroblade arrows. Shit, fam. Nope. So who has better luck? Me or Ronfar? No. Rip, I'll do that next time. But yeah, I don't know why who would want to auto fight here. Yeah, no, not this time. I'm gonna do it. Alright, so I'm gonna just get my small laser guns. We want the SFM guy, or he doesn't exist this time. We only got four nerds. Oh, yeah. Try it out. Oh, I can't jump over that one. This one's too thick. But I could probably jump over this guy. Maybe. Wow, rip. So what's the point of kicking? Crossbow hit me. Alright. See ya. Alright. Please, God, let us make money. Can you just walk over little units, too? Can you, like, stomp them? Or is kicking, like, the equivalent? RIP! Okay. We'll save this time in front. Actually, I got a better idea for a soundtrack we should listen to. Hold on. Alright. Whatever, we'll let it just auto-fight this time to see if this works. Whoa! Damn. That missile is pretty real. Dude, he's hitting the shit out of my thing, out of my mech. That graphic was kind of cool, too. Alright, cool. So now, go buy everything. Be long now. Okay, cool. We're getting close then. So now what? Go, you need 500 for the apprentice at the... Okay. Change investments. Sell stock. 500, okay. What is that one again? Well, I think it's one of the white buildings. Oh, really? Damn, that'd suck. Yeah, you really need to play out the marketing in this game. If you want to have, like, the best experience. Ask to apprentice. This course is taught by experience, not by any namby-pamby book learning. We also expect you to be remunerated for our time. Alright, yeah. The techs take you back into the shop and show you their techniques for grafting armor plate, repairing internal structure damage, and replacing damaged weapons and heat sinks. You can't grasp most of the technology, but you certainly feel more competent than you did before. All right. So now I should get paid again, right? Maybe or maybe not. I don't think it's happening. Yeah. All right, should I save then do the mission? Like just save at the mission front door? I guess so. Alright, so usual brain dead quiz. Our next mission. Welcome to the big time. Combat against another mech. You'll be engaging a remote controlled locust in a one-on-one situation. Use your training and skills to best your opponent. You will pass this test if you destroy the enemy while your mech is still standing. By the way, we've disabled your combat computer for this mission. If you're going to win, you'll have to do it yourself. Good luck. Alright. Oh, cool. It's telling me not to auto-fight. Alright, so where's this guy at? Alright, so it's a locust. Get some small lasers on it. Maybe a medium laser too, and then let's throw another one. Alright. So what's the point then of like training in different combat weapons then? Like what's the point of like the vibro blades, the bows? Like, because I'm always in a mech, I'm never on the ground. Like what's the purpose of that? Might as well jump. Jump! You may have to fight outside your mech. Oh, like if I had to, like, eject or some shit like that? Alright, so he's hiding like a nerd. No, I'm not trying to jump. Gotcha. Alright, so he's, like, kitty-corner to me here. Too bad I can't, like, lob a weapon, like a grenade or something. Oh, dude, hold on. I'm gonna shoot this thing in the back and it's gonna get bodied. Check this out. Technically, there is indirect fire, but only LRMs and a spotter. Okay. Can't run. Yo, I'm shooting at you point blank. Heat level's a little bit up. I'm gonna turn off the large laser. Just fucking kick his ass. Jason's mech uses a medium laser. Hit head. Hits my left leg. Oh, it is? Okay. Dude, we're just fighting point blank. critical. Dude, that's right. Nice. Oh. Didn't mean to do that. That's alright. Should be okay. I'm just having a point blank, Okay, cool, we did it. GG! Congratulations, you have defeated a mech in a one-on-one combat and taken your first step towards earning the title Mech Warrior. Now, go rest up and celebrate while we repair the mechs. Report back here later, and we'll take your ego down a couple of notches in your next test. Rick Atlas, one of the other cadets here at the training school, though much older than you, comes over to congratulate you on your victory. He tells you that he's going over to the lounge to relax and asks you if you want to stop by later to join him. You're a bit surprised, since he's never talked to you before, but you'll see him there. Don't talk to Rick yet. Yeah, we gotta check the monies. We gotta get paid first before we can hang out with Rick. Alright. Please profit. Please profit. Yes! What? Okay, cool, we're good. Sorry, I thought that, like, froze or something. Alright. Alright, money's deposited. We're good there. Let's go talk to Rick. Let's see what Big Riggs has got to say. Big Rick. Yo, I hope we get another pilot and we can name her. Make sure you don't get more money. Oh, yeah. I don't think I'm going to, but you never know. I'll walk for a little bit. We'll contemplate about our battle with the mech and our victory. Let's see here. Alright, so I'm in good health. What's a cudgel? Cudgel. Is that like a mace? I guess I could look it up real quick. A short, thick stick used as a weapon. Pfft. Yeah, fucking Cro-Magnon club. Just still kind of the same here. Alright, so let's go talk to Rick. Is it, like, are those training classes, like, not training me correctly? Ugh. No, the piloting, gunnery, or mech skills. Okay. So I need to go acquire mech skills then. Let's go talk to Rick Atlas. Okay. Rick invites you to sit at his table. The two of you are engaged in light, friendly conversation. When one of the senior techs stumbles by, he's clearly imberated. I think he's like drunk. I think that's what imberated means. Oh my god, I totally botched that word. Yeah, he's intoxicated. Cool. Yep. And is being none too friendly. He leans over to the table, spilling or deliberately pouring some of his Noxus beverage on you. Then breaks into laughter. You quickly stand up as if to challenge him, which makes him laugh even harder. Rick grabs your arm and hauls you back into your seat. He then interposes himself between you two and urges the burly tech to go on home. The tech starts to resist, griping loudly as to why some baby-faced kid with a famous... The tech starts to resist, griping loudly as to why some baby-faced kid with a famous daddy should be allowed to shoot up some valuable hardware, which he then has to fix up, just so this kid can shoot it up again. Stupid kid. Probably hasn't ever been to the starport even. Hey, man. Rick succeeds in ushering the tech out of the lounge and returns to the table. You sit somewhat dejectedly when Rick tells you to not take the drunk's comments personally. You respond that it's hard to keep high self-esteem after a barrage like that. Then Rick asks you if it's true that you've never been to the starport. When you grumble out a yes, he reaches into his vest pocket and pulls out a small electronic device, which he gives to you. When you ask what it is, he tells you that you'll know when you need to. Okay. Then he leaves. Oh, bye, Rick. See ya, boy. Alright, so we should be getting paid again, I think. There's another event. Looks like I'm not getting paid, which is fine. How much money do I currently have? Was it Pangus? No, Garode is the gentleman that did it. I don't know if he did the other Valhalla one that was before, no, it was David Nyman who did the other one. Both are great. Pangus? It's pretty good. I like the soundtrack. I like both of them. I still have yet to play Valhalla. But the music was already worth it. I was wowed by it. I wanted to see, where's the weapon store? Weapon store, weapon store, weapon store. Slug throwers. Should probably save. Okay. Save on game two. Looking for you'll have to enter a tech school if you want to learn more than you already know. Speed shop. Modifications, okay. Should I go do another mission? You're gonna need one of those armors. Well, should I be doing another mission or should I be buying some stuff? You might get paid one more time? Okay. Alright, well, let's go do this mission then. Now we're going to have your toughest test yet. You will have to face more mechs than you have previously. Get ready for the fight of your life. Okay. Let's see what we got here. No. Alright, so we got two locusts. Easy. Let's see here. Large laser target, small laser target, small laser next enemy target, and a medium laser target. Okay. Do a little Van Halen jump again. Alright, so that guy can't fucking shoot me because he's behind a building. So then... How do you miss kicking him? He's right there, bro. God damn it. Alright, here, yeah, let's just balls to the walls. Wow. Wow, what the f- I don't know. How do I... See, now, here's something that's really, like, aggravating me. I totally did nothing to him that turn. I didn't hit him. I didn't do anything. And now it's like, how do I rotate my character? Because, obviously, now, I'm in a bad position. Yeah. So what am I supposed to flee? Fuck it. Let's just... whatever. Or I'm not jumping. Oh, okay. Cool. Alright. Nice. Yarr, we did it. Maybe just bad pathing, I don't know. So is this pretty close to how the board game plays? Because honestly, I wouldn't mind playing this like a tabletop game. This is pretty cool. If like I could play a tabletop version, it would have been fun. And I think what I recall from you telling me about it back in the day, the game was pretty inexpensive. So this would have been the, this would have been a great solution for me because when I was growing up, I always wanted to play tabletop games. I always just was marveled by seeing the environments, the units, people's heart and passion they put into painting and constructing them. But Warhammer was so expensive I could never afford it. BattleTech would have been a great, great alternate solution. Yeah. And I mean, that's the thing I'm liking about this game. Stop talking, check the money. Wow, okay, Dad. Before it goes up again. Sorry I'm being a little passionate. Look, my money went up. I'm fine. I'm good. It's great. All right. Change your investments. Buy stock. 15. Yeah, see, let me talk more about the youth of me wanting to do tabletop. You got lucky. Oh, yeah. Alright, so let's save again quick. But yeah, the tabletop game is sweet. I forget, did you keep your squad, your team, or all your battle tech? I wouldn't even mind just to like buy some and collect them and like have a few of them on my table because they look sweet. I just wouldn't want to paint them because I don't know. I feel like that would be a lot of work, but that would be kind of the fun part. That would be kind of a cool stream, is constructing them and painting them. But I forget that if that's like that with Warhammer, like if BattleTech's the same kind of thing like that, because in Warhammer you had to build, construct, paint them. You had to do everything with them. Or maybe I could get Logic to help me with that. Maybe I could commission Logic to do it. He'd probably like that. Alright, so nothing's going up. What's our next course of action? Actually, I'm gonna get some more water quick, so I'll be right back in a moment. Alright, buy weapons and armor. Should I pull out all my money, or... Or go see how much everything costs first? Or am I at the point in the game now I can just... splurge everything? So what am I looking for from, like, the weapon shop? Am I looking for, like, a, Okay. Well, also rifles. I think I'm gonna buy a rifle then. Well, I want a rifle though. What's wrong with the rifle, though? I mean, it's only 80 bucks. It's not that big of a deal, in my opinion. Compared to all the other stuff I've had to, like, pay for so far in this game for, like, the training lessons. Probably find an inferno. Holy shit. Gelatinous goo. Wow. Shit. You think I should buy an Inferno then? Get an Inferno and submachine gun? Probably. Okay. Well, I bought it. The shopkeeper hands the weapon. Same dude. I would love Cruiserweights to have their own pay-per-view. The shopkeeper hands you the weapon and gives you some brief instructions on how to use it properly. Don't point it at nobody unless you're gonna kill him, etc. Then he tries to imitate a respectable business owner by wishing you a good day and hoping that you will visit him for all your weaponry needs. Okay. Alright, cool. So, I got a rifle and the, Oh, yo, my piloting is adequate now. That's good. Gunnery is amateur, too. Not bad. Getting better. Alright, so now I need to go buy armor. Dude, I hope, though, like, what they could do is mix, like, NXT and cruiserweights together. So, like, when there's an NXT pay-per-view, they could put the cruiserweights with NXT. That would be really hype. I think people would like that. I think fans really would. Actually, and also, I don't know if you saw it today or not, but today marks the 2-year anniversary of the Cruiserweight Classic. Crazy how the cruiserweights have been around for 2 years now. Yeah, man, it'd be a lot more fitting. It's Triple H's product now, so... What kind of armor should I get? Should I just get, like, a flak vest or a... Nah. I'm not certain about this kind of armor. I actually was talking to my brother the other day and he kind of had this epiphany. Might want to read what they do. Oh, okay. Yeah, here. Let's just pause a moment on WWE here. I mean, I think that's a good thing. They're making themselves their own entity, their own brand, their own thing. Excellent craftsmanship marks this triple mesh cloth and metal fiber suit of armor. It's designed to protect against slugs and arrows. It's laser weapons, lightweight. Okay, so it's 25. Alright, so this is definitely an upgrade to it. Yeah, but I think the one second here. Hang on. So this is a step up. Rating of 30. But they're cheaper to repair than flak suits. Oh. Okay, they limit your mobility. Oh, 10,000? Yeah, that's how I feel about that. That is a lot of money. Are they?
That was pretty wizard.
But here's the thing, like, I'd rather get the flak suit, yeah. Oh, it's a black market item, huh? They're very expensive to repair. Yeah, let's go with the flak suit. That sounds like a good choice. Alright. So we got some guns for my little boy. We also got a flak suit. And then we're... Do I need to go buy a mech? Or how does that work now? Save on one. But here's the point I'm getting at, Ray, is like 205 Live. I'm great. It's its own entity now. I'm very happy that Triple H is making its own thing. It feels very similar to NXT, but it being an all-male roster, like the way that they are marketing, you'll get a mech as the story continues. Oh, cool. Thanks, McTeddy Plays. By the way, welcome. Hello. I think with 205 Live, the thing that people need to know is it's directed towards, like, me and Pete's audience. That's the demographic. I think even, like, young boys, too, who like wrestling. But it's definitely, like, the, like, late night older wrestling. Like, I feel like that's who it's directed towards. It's not directed really towards kids. It's more towards smarks like me. So, that's how I feel. That's why I enjoy that product more than, like, Raw and SmackDown. Greetings and salutations. Alright, Mom. So, we're saved. We got some guns. We got some armor. Sin Cara. I do another training mission. Should I go put my money back into the, back into the stock? Yeah, I mean, that's the way to go. Some SmackDown, some NXT. I mean, honestly, right now, if you're not watching NXT, you're missing out. The storylines in there are really good, in my opinion. They're probably the best storylines for anyone who watches that WWE product. Change your investments, buy stock. And 3007. Oh, okay. That'd be a decent pre-show match. Alright, and then we'll save on 2. Let's go do another mission. Yeah, definitely having other music playing in the background kind of helps enhance the experience for this game too. Before you can go on the mission, you'll have to pass the Brain Dead Easy Quiz and the 7th training mission. Now we're going to have your toughest test yet. You will have to face more mechs than you have previous. Get ready for a fight of your life. I mean, okay, I gotta fight more. Alright. The mechs are unlike any of you fought against. You feel uneasy. Okay, a bunch of locusts. Can I actually, like... One thing I wish I could do is, like, view the map, like, kind of do, like, a free look. But I can't. They look like locusts. Oh, are they Jenners? I guess that's what they're called. They got a bunch of medium lasers and SRM missile as well. Alright. Gotcha. I mean, it'd be nice. It'd be, you know, that's feedback. You know, that was the thing that I always loved about Fire Emblem, Final Fantasy Tactics, Advance Wars. You know, the free look. It kind of, you know, it helps you pan things out. I mean, you know, when you're playing BattleTech 2, the tabletop version, I mean, you can see the whole board and plan what you need to do, but it's all good at the end of the day. Alright, I think I'm going to try something a little unique this time. I'm going to go hide in the woods, and are lacking in convenience. And I mean, you know, that was the thing though with some games back in the day. But I mean, it's not terrible though. It's not bad. It's not like making me like, oh, fuck this game, I'm gonna throw it in the trash. It's just, you know, a little nitpicky detail that would, you know, would be nice. That's all I'm getting at. But it's not like Fester's Quest, Simon's, you know, Castlevania 2, Simon's Quest. or like, you know, it's not like a, it's not terrible. It's tolerable. It just, you know, would be nice. All right, so let's go here. They're trying to actually kill you. This is no training mission. Holy Hannah. I don't... First time playing that. Yeah. I mean, technically second time, but like the first time, your mom, he's been kind of helping me break down and learn about this game. He's the one who requested this game to play for me. Hey, what's good? Alright, cool, we got one. I mean, so far, it's a pretty sweet game. Oh, there's fire burning over there. What? I'm playing a game called BattleTech. It's, think of, like, westernized, like, Gundam, if you will. Dude, my guy looks pretty badass. The opening is the strongest part of the game. Okay. What do you mean by the opening? Like, like the first graphic of the game? This game looks rad, says Barley. Hey, Barley. It's different. Welcome to Wheel of Rip, gentlemen, by the way. It's every Friday, day out of the week, I have a huge list of fan-requested games, and just kind of tackle them. This one's kind of special, though. So I've been getting a little help on this one. Basically until after the battle. Oh, okay. Gotcha. Oh, okay. Okay. I might be spectating tomorrow at Red Bull. I got work tomorrow. So, I'm hoping when I get off I can make it over there. But we'll see how the day plays out. You feel it hurts the game? Okay. So let's see here. I mean, everything's still kind of the same with targeting. I gotta get closer though. Can't run too much. Oh, hey, I appreciate that. I'm really enjoying this game. Hell yeah, dude. Yeah, man, there's people that are coming out to compete here, so I'm really excited to see with mainly Guilty Gear. I always love watching Guilty Gear. All right, let's see here. So we got a miss. Torso. I mean, good thing I'm hiding in the woods, right? Oh my gosh. I'm getting kind of lit up over here. Oh, Citadel's been destroyed too. Oh man, we're getting like invaded. Should I flee? Cannot escape these Jenners. Well, I'm hitting him.
What the hell? My guy looked like a hella dork.
Dude, I'm getting shot up. Yeah, true. Curitans must have raided Pacifica and destroyed your army. Oh my god. I mean, it's weird after each turn, like, the plot thickens, but... Movement is... Oh no. My lasers are destroyed too. They broke down the southeast wall. Oh, cool. All right, so here we go. Curitan mechs have made a lightning raid on Pacifica. They have destroyed the citadel. One of the Curitan Jenner mechs tries to crush you in your mech's cockpit, but you barely escape like Luke Skywalker in Episode 5 before the deadly blow can cut you down. You manage to hide in the trees. Some of the remnant of the Lyran Guard engage the mechs. Your comrades are wiped out, but in the distraction, you manage to escape. Wait, what about all that money I had? Couldn't I have used it for more classes, or... I mean, I guess we'll find out. Your friends from the Citadel, the ones who are still alive, are scattering, trying to avoid their executioners. You overhear scraps of shouted conversation. Who are they? What do they want? Curitan invaders! They've destroyed our army! Where was Jeremiah? I don't know, nobody's seen him. He's probably dead. You stand numb for a moment, contemplating what you've just overheard. An explosion behind you jars you back to reality. What do you want to learn? I mean, I'm all about taking L's. It's not about losing, it's about learning. It's kind of a mantra here in my stream channel. And you make your make up your mind as to your course of action. Since I mean, I have a save file saved, so worst case scenario, if this plays out, I can always go back. So it's all good. And you make up your mind as to your course of action. Since the Citadel is overrun, there is no reason for you to hang around here. You realize that your only chance is to try to make it to the starport, meet up with anyone you may know. Try to find out if your father is still alive and get a ride off this planet before it's too late. Yeah, maybe we'll bump into Rick. Oh, now I'm a little dude. Oh, shit. Yeah, I mean... sure. Don't I have weapons? Maybe I don't. I need to go find the starport, I guess. I did buy weapons, yes. I bought a Inferno and a rifle, but did I not equip them? Hmm. Oh, the rifle is equipped. Okay. It was just weird. The combat didn't feel like a Oh. Why is my thing, like, stuck? Oh my god, what the fuck? Weird. That was really weird. Like, I must have been stuck in an auto-computer fight. Well, now I'm kind of questioning what to do now. No, it's all good. Yeah. Definitely take your money. Yeah. Let's go buy some stuff. Or just have it to hold on to, I suppose. Then I can just auto-fight the computer. Yeah, so I have the rifle. Get some weapon classes if you can afford it. So, as in going back to here. I don't need weapon classes. I mean, I could get up another one here. Do you want me to do another rifle and SMG? I mean, yeah, Mom's been giving me some perspective. He knows quite a bit of this game, so he was saying focus on the rifles and SMGs. You can't. Oh, that's max then. I'm speculating. You can't go up any higher. Because then that means that's why I'm excellent at the rifle. Yeah, that would make sense. Because we gotta go do the mission, which is gonna get us... Yeah, because this is the point in the game where it's like... When you do this last mission, what I feel like happens is like... The tutorial game is over. It's done. Like, the real game begins. You can't come back here. You have to leave. Whatever you've done and accomplished is what it is. Oh, cool. This is done. That was a fun soundtrack. Should be good. This is some Snatcher OST. Right. So after this, there are only a few trainers, so if you didn't learn now, ouch. I mean, yeah, but I was, from what I've been told, like, I only need to focus in, rifles. My knowledge of the game is all pretty low. Well, you know more than I do. I will say that. So, okay. Yeah, you'll be fine, I think. Alright. I'm gonna go do this mission then. So, then got on those foot. Yeah, those foot battles are weird. Just want to stay out of their territory. Oh, cool. So now I can run the hell out of here. Southeast wall. Okay, cool. Alright, so they're still trying to follow me. Jumping gets through woods faster. Can't jump that way, huh? I think I can keep running. All right, cool. There's still quite a ways away, so we're doing good. We're looking good. So far. Oh shit, they're shooting at me. Aw, shit. Well, that's too bad. Gotta Metal Gear my way out of here. Yep. Positioning's important. Oh no. Okay. God damn. Am I gonna run in a circle forever? I don't even know where the frick the starport is. I mean, see, but here's the thing, like, I would have fleed, sure, even with the mech, but it's, like, still, like, I have no idea where the starport is. This map is freaking huge. No, I don't want to engage in combat. I want to go to the starport. Holy shit, it's like one of those maps that goes forever. I don't even know how to look at them. Oh, show over. Oh. Holy shit, this is huge. Northwest. Oh, yeah. Jason's probably gonna die. Because I'm not in a mech. There's a lot of these people. Now the game has become frustrating. Now I've like hit a point where I'm like not as much having fun. Alright, so let's get back here then. See what I mean? Yep. But see, that's what you're saying about learning and all that. You know, it's totally... By the way, McTeddy plays. Thank you for the follow. It gets better once you have a team. Oh, I bet. Right now, it's still kind of the struggle point. All right, let's save game this time. All right. Chameleon... No. Actually, I got a better idea. shit. Alright. Yeah, I'm just gonna get shot the hell up. They're missing quite a bit. Yeah, the woods did have better cover. All I can do is fucking jump. Well, that's not gonna help. Oh my god. Yeah, and you can't even, like, I can't even reload a save point. Like, I have to play it through. So all I can do is just jump for the fucking life of me. Yep. Okay, so then load game. Here we go again. Alright, try the other route using the forest. That's tough. Okay, no. Jump over. See, you gotta be careful. You gotta be patient with, like, the movement and everything, too. Because if not, you're gonna get in big trouble. Right. God, they're missing. Thank God. Okay. Allocate men in max. Change game settings. Inspect character. You can inspect a man or a mech. Do you want to inspect a mech? Yes. So, two of my lasers are out. Yeah, true. Yeah. Decent condition. Heat sinks are kind of fucked. So you're saying I need to go northwest? Right. My right torso. Is what it is. Alright. But now I can kill all these little people. But no one's gonna fuck with me now. Till I bump another max. Sure. Alright, scan enemies. Uh-oh. Maybe. They don't have much. Okay. Oh, yeah. That one is Crescent Hawk's Revenge, right? Nice. Some enemy humans have fled. Cool. Alright, kick this guy. Uh-oh. Cool, I destroyed a mech. How's my mechanic skill? I don't think I even have mechanic skills. Allocate men and mechs. Thank you. Yeah, that left arm was my good arm, too. Okay. Alright, so you're saying I need to go northwest to the spaceport? See combat graphics? Yes. Dude, you guys aren't worth it. Oh, you get gunnery and piloting for fighting. Oh, okay, you get EXP and everything, okay. Six humans, sure. No, sword. Yes, hit the mech with a sword. I mean, it's a vibroblade. Oh, they're running away. Dude, this music's perfect right now. Okay, we got 7 C-bills. Do you want to drop your rifle in exchange for a vibroblade? No. Okay. Oh, the other dude had a vibroblade. Yeah, I mean... Alright, no. Alright, scan enemies. Locus, fiberblade, pistol, sword. Okay. Enemy mech uses a medium laser on Jason's mech. Some of the enemy humans have fled. I mean, where's my Inferno, right? Where's my Inferno weapon I bought? What a shitload of fuck. There goes my arm. Yeah, it seems so. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. I'm fighting a real boy here. Uh-oh. Well, he's got defeated. I need to get out of here, though. That's my issue. No, I don't want to fight you guys. This map is making no sense to me either, but... You want? Sure. It's likely they'll harm you. Alright, cool. Oh, the map, like where it's pointing. Should I save, by the way? Huge, I mean, I could save on another file. Here, I'll just do this. I'll just save on 5. Area, yeah. These maps are very big. Sure. Okay. Oh, here we go. We made it. Oh, west. Duh. Like, I should probably just follow the arrows, because that's where it's telling me where to go. No, that's the jail. Oh, okay. Making some bucks. You're in it. Okay. gonna see. Excellent amateur. Okay. Okay. It's close. I didn't see the arrows don't tell you where to go. Yeah. Go up this way then. Oh, I think I'm supposed to. I kind of baited myself on buying those weapons. No, it does follow the arrow. Oh, okay. So you're telling me. Okay. It's right here then. We're close then, like you were saying. Starport. Run, boy, run! Alright. Wow, at this point, alright. Dude, you don't suck. You don't suck. You're trying to help. I greatly, like... You guys are being very wonderful. Save on game one now. Alright, so should I go to the mech garage here and get repaired up? No, I mean, I beat this game and didn't even notice the arrow. I mean, you were, but you said you were looking at a guide, right? Shop, huh? Gotcha. Not bad. Alright, I'm gonna go in the garage. Sure. Kill these kids. Take their bills. Alright, you have walked into a huge mech parking garage. Since mechs are not allowed in the starport, anyone with mechs wishing to enter the starport must park his mech here. I mean, totally! Totally! If I was a mech pilot, I would want a map of wherever I am. Not some, I mean, it's like, think about it, right? Like, think of like Zelda on NES, right? I recall being a kid, you know, that game you had to remember a lot of shit. It would have been nice to be in like, here's a map, figure out where you need to go. I mean, that was kind of the cool thing with the manuals back in the day. The manual, I think, gave you a snippet of the map, but I do also have a old NES player's guide that had a full map of it too. Oh, really? It's not canon? Huh. Cool. That's neat. Alright, so... the parking garage manager approaches you and asks you if you want to leave your vehicles here in this fine... sure. You guide your mechs into the garage and take the receipts offered you. You are told that you will be expected to pay for the services when you leave the starport. Alright. True. But you know what game had cities on the NES? Faxanadu. One of the coolest underrated RPGs of all time, in my opinion. Alright, combat? No, I'm not trying to... Why is there combat here in the starport? Mm-hmm. Give swords a light way to lonely people. I'm like enemy number one over here. I need to figure out my next course of action. It's really weird that there's combat here in the starport, like... kind of baffled as to why. Like, what's the continuity there? They can't even bring their mechs in here. Nah, I already have what I need. Oh man, there's a... is that like a mech tournament arena over here? It looks like one. Oh yeah, let's inspect my character. Armor has not been injured. Okay. No, I don't want to engage you in combat. I'm trying to explore the city. Inaugural Hall. You peek your head through the door and see a huge auditorium. On the walls... and from the roof, you see hanging banners with something you've never thought you would see on Pacifica, the Kurita Dragon. Some posters on the wall, on the walls are proclaiming the inauguration of the new Puritan government at ceremony tonight in this place. Oh, okay. Oh, all right, dude. Well, McTeddy plays. Dude, thank you for hanging. I hope to see you around more. Just a little quick thing about me. I play variety games. My schedule down below kind of gives a whole recap of what I do. And, you know, I'll see you around, dude. Have a good night. Enjoy your weekend. Core in the house, baby. You know where to find me. Some workers are installing equipment on the stage, and you decide that your Lyran Special Forces uniform probably wouldn't... over too well with them, since you don't want to run in with the enemy just yet. Close the door quickly. So that's going on. That's going on. That's why I'm a wanted enemy, is because of my clothing. I need to go find somewhere then to get some clothes. Hospital looks like to get healed me up, obviously. We need to go find a clothing store or something. because I'm probably a wanted criminal. Wish I knew where the clothing store is. Ah, here we go. You have entered a clothing store where all types of civilian clothes are for sale. The proprietor eyes you anxiously. Obviously, your Lyran Special Forces uniform is making him nervous because there could be a shootout here in any draconian soldiers were to see you here. You head for the dressing room and quickly change into your new set of clothes. You feel a relief knowing that you don't stand out in the crowd anymore. Okay, well, apparently people still want to fucking kill me. Fun fact. Or maybe it's done now, maybe... I mean, I'm still engaged in combat. Don't know why that's a thing. Nobody's in the lounge. Here. Hell yeah. Alright, talk to others. Jeff Rogers. Oh, okay. Okay, I guess they're not... They don't want to talk to me. I'm still really confused that I changed my clothes and everyone here still wants to kill me for no specific reason. Ah, the Comstar Center. Great. Part 2. There's gotta be some other building here. Go where that arena is, I think. Yeah. I want to get in here somehow if I can. But I have no idea what's going on over here. Yep. Ah, Mechat Lube. Here we go. But this is the part that's getting complicated now. Like, should I go put my money first? Have mechs repaired. Only 800 bills. Okay. Need to come up with some cash before you can get finished. I guess... your weapon estimate for you had some damage, however, you don't have the 200 bills. Okay, well, did the best I can. I want to get in this arena here, but no idea how to get in there. Oh, here we go. Enter the arena. Welcome to the arena where modern-day gladiators duel in the Colosseum in the 30th century. Here you can challenge another mech warrior in combat. The winner gets a 500 cash reward. Loser may get to live. Now, hold on a second. I'm going to save on slot 3 here. And then let's go in the arena and give this a whirl. The attendant, a shriveled old woman with horn-rimmed glasses, takes a long puff of her cigarette and pushes registration form your way in between bronchial coughs. She points to a certain places on the form for you to initial, releasing the arena management from any liability. She tells you that you can rent a mech from the arena or use your own. Do you want to rent a mech? No. I'll use my own. You're forced to sign several waivers releasing the arena operators from any liability. Should your mech be destroyed, if it is destroyed in arena combat, you lose it forever. Scraps become arena property. Alright. Maybe I should play safe and... I thought they didn't do much damage, though. Barley! Thank you as well for the follow, dude. Mucho appreciated. Officially welcome to Cory in the house. Yeah, but it's better than overheating. Oh, well said. Oh, this mech has overheated and shut down. Oh my god. Well, I think, I might have to reload because this is RIP. I need to let it cool down, I think. Okay. Check this out. Thank you. The nasty one behind the counter cackles out a feeble congratulations on your victory. She hands you 500 C-bills, much of which will go to repair your mech. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, well, apparently my guy's trash. Looks like your mech has lost about of armor if you want those replaced. Right, so the whole point is the grind up right now. You've got some damage for 200 bills. Okay, cool, so now we're all good to go. Heat sinks. Okay, don't bother real. Oh, well, too late there. Okay, gotcha. Alright, so I need to go win another fight then. Alright, so let's save. But should I be doing shit at the Citadel as well, so I can try to make more money then? Let's save on 6. I'm pretty sure I can. It seemed like I could. I think after fights, so like here, let's do this. So let's go like 7, let's go like 100, right? Oh, also no one's fighting me anymore. Yeah, we'll see. I'm just gonna test it. Feels a lot bigger now and more open. Like, this is gonna take a few Fridays. I don't know if I can beat this. Like, obviously it's almost 1 o'clock. I gotta call it soon here, but yeah, I mean, there's a lot more to this game, and it sucks because I don't think I'm gonna beat this in like another Friday. I feel like this might take like 5 or 6 Fridays, and right, yeah, I don't know. This game's longer than like a typical Friday one. Like, could be a bit longer. I want to save on 5. Okay, go to the arena. Let's give it a try. Do you want to run mech? No. Use my chameleon. And we'll just auto battle. 24-hour stream. Done those before. I'm good. I'm all about work-life balance. Just sometimes the hard life of being a variety broadcaster. We'll do an auto fight. Alright, so we got a hit. Got another crit. Hits my head. We're losing parts here. Alright, so now here's the real test. No, I don't want to fight you guys. I'm a nice boy, alright? I'm just in the arena, doing my thing. I'm gonna become a pilot. And as you can see, it did decline. So that means then my theory is correct. So let's load game. No, I don't want to fight you guys. Yeah. Well, that's good. Can get a lot of money that way. Yeah, hopefully that can speed up the process here. I'm probably going to just do this once to make it And then I'm gonna try to at least make this bank thing work once, and then after that, probably call it a night because it's getting a little late. All right, so then leave, save game on slot 4. Wait, it already went up. Oh, probably because of after the fight. Oh my god, yeah. Holy shit. It's probably because of after events. So anything can like trigger it. Ooh. Yeah, so then what I'm gonna do is it's time-based, okay. I'm gonna get all this money back then, because... Oh, far is bad now, because we don't know. So, what's more worth it then? Who do you think is the better company to invest into? Now then just keep doing it till I have an infinite money. Yeah, I'm gonna have to be careful. Yeah, let's see. Oh, I know. I just want enough money so I can just repair my guy as good as new. I think that's the plan. I might have overextended. Yeah, I see. A lot of grinding in this game. All right, there we go. Dude, you know what's kind of funny? You know what this reminds me of? So, in Fire Emblem, this is very reminiscent of stat rolling. And, nah, dude, I want 50,000. I want 50,000 points like in Double Dragon. But yeah, you would just keep, like, kind of, like, resetting a save state till you got the
that
right...
That was pretty wizard.
Till you wanted the right stats that you wanted. And we don't want that. Wait, so what is this game anyways? Barley, this game is, it's BattleTech. It's based off a cool old-school tabletop game from back in the day. You pilot a mech, and it's the story of Jason Youngblood, and your father is a famous captain pilot, and you know you're kind of living your life, and well, where you were living and training got taken over by bad guys, and now you're kind of like on the run trying to figure out what to do. Think of Han Solo, but instead of being a famous, being a smuggler, you're a pilot, but like a starfighter pilot, if you will. It looks rad. What year did it come out? Oh, man. This guy says the word rad. Love it. I probably have all my money gone. Ooh, 4, 5, 3, 8. That's better. I think Mom said it came out 88 or 86? Lol. Dude, we're all about being rad here. But yeah, I just want to make sure I got my, Okay. Ooh, even better. GT. Nice. Alright, so now we have a good amount of funds. F-Zero OST. Hell yeah, I'm glad you detected that. That's the life I live. A young man who's very nostalgic on the classics of gaming. Yeah, I mean, the big thing about me, Barley, is I used to be really big into fighting games and streamed that quite a lot, but now I'm kind of done with that and moving forward and focusing more on Twitch, and I'm a big variety broadcaster, and the big thing I focus on is I play role-playing games Thursday and Sunday nights. Friday nights, I play games requested by my community. Monday nights is kind of like a play whatever I feel like. And then Tuesday nights are like single-player backlog games that I've always wanted to get around playing or kind of re-experiencing. So, that's kind of what I do every week. And also, I see you're a partnered streamer. Care to share a bit about yourself? What do you play? What do you do? Totally. And just like for who I am as a person... I'm not a one game person anymore. I can't just play one game every day. And I don't know, I think it's more, you know, variety's good because I think it's more about the personality of the streamer than more so about just like, I don't know, the game sometimes. I mean, games are important, yes. But, you know, I think the importance is like having fun and, you know, getting to be you. And that's hard sometimes when you're just playing one game, and I don't know, I really haven't had, like, a single game. Oh, dude. One of my close friends, actually, he bought a copy of Lester the Unlikely at our local mom-and-pop game store, and when I went to go hang out at his apartment, I see his video game collection, and I see his Super Nintendo and what game's in there. Lester the Unlikely. Lester's a freaking nerd. When's he gonna be in Smash? Alright, I'm gonna take my investments. I play variety retro mostly, usually horror and shooter base. I also do modern bad, good horror sometimes. Oh, so you're all about the spooky games. I like spooky games too. I used to play quite a bit of spooky games. But I mean, look at you. You're partnered in your variety. That's rad, dude. Yeah, my big thing is just, for myself as a broadcasting streamer, because of, like, I've been streaming for about now 3 years, but it wasn't until I got my affiliate last year that I was like, all right, let's take things up a notch. And, since I have people now paying me to watch my show and content, I'm like, well, let's make this a real show. Let's make this a real thing. So it's kind of what I get to do now, and it's sweet, you know? Yeah, you and Corey should get along. Oh, dude, the medieval remake. Dude, this guy doesn't even know. He doesn't even know. I'm the biggest... Dude, it's great. This is going to be a great year for gaming because of Medieval Remake and the Spyro Remake. People always have enjoyed... I play the Spyro Trilogy every single year, and I'm so excited this year. I get to play the HD Trilogy Remake, and I'm probably going to cry the whole entire playthrough. And I can't wait. It's one of the closest games to me ever growing up. Like, it's passion, it's love. PlayStation, dude. I grew up on Nintendo, Super Nintendo, and PlayStation. And, you know, getting to be a young kid in the 90s, it was a hell of a fun time. So. And there's so many fun games I missed out that I get to experience now playing on Twitch because of people recommending or, like, you know, throwing out all these cool recommendations and just like, hey, try out this game or play this old game. That's what I love about, like, my Friday show is because I get to tackle games, and sometimes if I'm, like, done with it, I'm done with it. I mean, last week I played Myst for the first time. And, cool game, hard as shit. I've mostly been doing PS1 recently, catching up on a lot of games. Medieval was one of my faves as a kid. I've actually have played Medieval once, and it was one of the PlayStation demos. You know, you probably empathize with me too. You recall back in the day when demos were a thing. Alright, so I need to get my money out of here. Sorry, now I just want to talk. But hey, BattleTech's been very good so far. And I do want to play it more, it's just... I hope this game isn't going to take a bunch of Fridays. I really am enjoying it. It's a lot deeper than I anticipated for an old school game. Alright, I'm going to go get my mech repaired here. Yeah, Medieval is sweet. I actually, if you played PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale... I also love Ape Escape, by the way. I'm a big Ape Escape boy, too. But I played a lot of Sir Daniel Fortescue in PlayStation All-Stars, Smash Clone, Battle Royale. Never forget. But yeah, let's go get stuff repaired up here. Oh no, I don't want your stuff. I want... let's see here... Alright, cool. So... We don't have a deal in that type of mech. Oh, okay. Alright, well, I guess I'm good there. So now what? Just go do some auto battles? One game I'm really excited to play is Octopath Traveler. Picked it up today. Haven't gotten to play it yet. I'm going to hopefully get to play it a bit tomorrow night. I'm really looking forward to that, too. Yeah, I mean, there's some sweet games coming out right now. And it's been weird for me because of, like, I don't know, I haven't had a new game come out that's really been, like, pulling me in. Digging the obscure nature of the games here. Oh, totes. No, I'm not gonna fight anyone. No, thank you. But I do want to go to the arena. Where is the arena entrance once more? Oh, hey, here we go. A little Mute City for ya. Oh, and dude, Barley. I got a feeling, too, you're excited for Smash Ultimate. I got a hunch. You like old school gaming. I think me and you kind of think the same. Oh, you know what that also excites me? My favorite 3DS stage is going to be in Smash Ultimate. The F-Zero one. The Super Nintendo. Like, that was probably one of my favorite stages. Is, on Smash Ultimate, or on 3DS, is, Ness's other level in the Dream Realm with the Flying Men. Magiscant. And, probably botched it. And then, God, what's the other level? I just said it. Mute City on Super Nintendo. Godlike. Alright. Should I just rent a mech? Mom, what do you think about that? Should I rent a mech? Since I have all this money. And Barley, what's up? My biggest unpopular opinion, it's not... Oh, you're not a huge Smash fan, then... Hey, you know what? Hey, it's totally fine. Hey, man. Everyone's got their own taste. Cheers. Alright, then no, I'm gonna use mine then. I'm gonna go dumpster these guys. Yo, this guy's getting... Yo, pooped on. It's all good though, dude. We seem to align on everything else. Oh, hell yeah. Yo, I'm definitely gonna drop a follow when I'm done broadcasting, by the way. What's your stream schedule typically then, my dude? Oh man, good bumper as well. By the way, F-Zero on Super Nintendo is one of the greatest racing games of all time. Super cool. I'm glad I got to play that. Let's see here. Oh man, that's so cheap! Hell yeah! Let's go keep beating ass. Let's do it. Alright, let's keep it up. Just autopilot grind, I guess, for a bit. Oh, I guess I borrowed one. Do you want the computer to fight? Sure. I might have goofed up here. We'll see how this, hopefully I don't blow up and die. I should have said no, accidentally. I made a possible mistake. Uh-oh, sad boy face. Oh, cool. Cool animation. Nope, hitting the face again. Hey, dude, it's all good. Okay, well, we won. I got 250 out of it. Got about 350. No, I want to use... Oh! Do you want to give it a... Yes. No, I want to use mine. Because I got the best mech in North America. Oh, hey, Barley. I got another question then for you. You like spooky games. Resident Evil 2 HD. What's your opinion on that then? Oh man, that kid got dumpstered. Let's go repair up again. Oh yeah, it's so cheap, dude. Love it. Big money, big prizes. I love it. Oh man, should I make that a sound effects for us? All right, so probably after this one, I'm gonna save. Jason! Technical. My piloting's good. That's new. Alright. Oh, your net dropped? Oh, okay. So, I think what my plan is I'm going to do one more repair. You know what's hilarious, by the way? I was going to say, what's your opinion on Resident Evil 2 HD? If you like the spooky games. Or, you know, if you like Resident Evil or not, the franchise. Or maybe you don't like Capcom. Many people don't like Capcom as much anymore with what they've done to the fighting games. Dude, it looks fantastic. Yeah, I think some of the stuff that they're working on, like, excluding the fighting games, like, what they've done with Resident Evil looks good. Devil May Cry looks promising. Mega Man 11 looks good. It's just, I can't trust Capcom with their fighting games. That's just me. Alright, I'm gonna get one more battle in here. And then, probably save and call it a night. Do you want the computer to fight for you? Yes, please. See combat graphics? I don't know, yeah. Ooh. That's not good. My mech got blown up. I'm probably gonna reload from my old spot. Alright, load game one. Okay, we're not too far back here. Let me see here. You can't afford to lose it, right? Ooh. I personally really like DOA4 music. That's just me. Alright, you know, let's just do this fight then I'll save. Yeah, you should use this one though. Give it a try, yes. But yeah, I'll need to kind of check to see what to do next. But yeah, you should use this one though. Yeah, just RNG it. Come on, Jason. Okay, Ned is totally dead, lol. Oh, okay. Alright, let's go get repaired up then, and then we'll save and call it a night. Alright, cool. Alright, sweet. Upstairs on Data. Yeah. Never. The good old Data. The good old cell phone smart device. Data. All right. I'm going to save one more time for good measure. All right, everybody. I'm going to call it with that tonight, I think. So, also to the people who watch us on YouTube with the archives, thank you so much. And hopefully we'll get a part 2 of BattleTech. So.